Yes, ladies and gentlemen, I'm here with the winning debutante, Wei Rui. Fantastic victory for you against Akimoto, former champion. This feels like a very significant win for you. How significant does this win feel?
Fine.
女士们、先生们，今天我们采访到了刚刚的这个胜者魏瑞先生，也是战胜了之前的冠军，邱元选手。那么我知道这次比赛的胜利对您来说是非常重要的，您可以向我们解释一下这个胜利到底有多重要吗？首先一个，这是我们中国就是站立踢拳选手、自由搏击选手在腕，这是首先对阵的是一个前冠军。 而且我们中国选手有两名选手都已经赋予这个选手了，所以这一次不只是证明我个人我自己，更是证明中国踢拳在于这个腕的这样的一个成绩这样的一个高度的一个表现。
I think before me there are already two Chinese athletes in kickboxing that lose in the challenge with this Japanese athletes, and I am the first one to win him in kickboxing here in one championship. And so I think that is not only proving that my ability, and also it's a proof to the whole Chinese athlete team.
You put together an unbelievable winning streak. What does that say about you as a fighter and as a man? How special are you to be able to achieve this?
您这个在每场比赛的胜利可以说是非常的锐不可挡，那么您有什么这个绝技可以跟我们分享一下吗？或者说您是怎么样去赢得每场比赛的这个胜利，保持这样的一个非常勇猛的劲头？首先，无论这个作为选手也好，做什么事情也好，我觉得要有一个信念，我觉得我的信念源于我的这个家庭，源于我的这个团队，所以我会秉承我的这个信念。 然后一直坚持不懈地去奋斗。还有一个，刚才他说到为什么我的比赛锐不可挡，可能就是跟我的名字一样嘛，魏瑞锐不可挡。而且我们的这个衣服上全是这个水的这个 logo， 无论是胜也好，败也好，我觉得最重要的就是一个信念，在擂台上的一个表现。我可以失败，但是我的信念没有败，所以我可以胜利，我的信念会一直胜利。所以我觉得人要坚守一个就是信念。
I think belief is very important for athletes and also for human beings, for everyone. That's game. Sometimes you win, sometimes you lose, but as long as you keep the belief, and then you will never be defeated. I think another reason, probably because of my name, Wei Rui. Rui means sharp, and the streak, Chinese, and see, we got the Chinese character Rui on all of our clothes and on our flag. Probably that is one of the reasons.
Of course, Japanese fans are not happy about the decision. They saw you get knocked down and they thought that their fighter won. Could you help educate us, in your opinion, why did you win this fight? How did you win this fight?
首先，这一次比赛，首先一个还是根据这个规则来说，我觉得还是规则是偏于技术型然后就是针对于得分得点，而且日本对于我的这个质疑，他说我被打倒了，首先一个我没被打倒，而且对手貌似给了我重击，但是其实是没有，只是角度的问题所以对手没有完全的重创我。 反而我一直在控制着对手，一直在牵引着对手。我觉得我的这个战术布置，还有整场比赛的表现，我觉得赢他是没有问题的。First
thing, just as I stressed before, I think I want to explain a little bit about the rules and regulations. Our rules focus more on points and techniques. Probably some Japanese fans think that I am knocked down by him. Actually, that's not the case. And they think Hiroki hit me very hard, but actually that's probably just from the different angles. And he didn't harm me, he didn't really hurt me. And I take most control of the whole game. So I think, I feel from the whole picture, from the bigger picture, I deserve the victory.
Well, the win is yours. So do you have a message for Mr. Jonathan Haggerty, the champion?
Haggerty.
对您对于这个现在金腰带的持有者Jonathan先生有没有什么想说的话呢？我想对哈，我想对哈格蒂说，准备好，我马上就过来。我想把这个荣誉金腰带，我想留在中国，留在我们唐山，留在我们唐山文旅集团。
I want to say, get ready, I'm coming for you. I am coming for the belt. I want to take the belt back to China, back to my hometown, Taoshan.
Haggerty has put on some big performances. He's probably at the peak of his powers. You're 34, an amazing win streak, maybe at the peak of your powers. Can fans expect something legendary if you were to fight Haggerty for the belt?
那您现在已经是有了非常好的34场这个连胜的记录了，那么如果您能再去夺得这个金腰带的话，可以说就可以创造拳击界的一个神话。嗯，对，因为我前期有很多荣誉，但是我这一次选择向万冠军这个发起冲击，我也是在秉承我们中国武术格斗的一个发展的一个使命，我想。 中国的踢拳在世界，我觉得通过我们每个人的努力，我觉得中国的踢拳在世界上一定会慢慢被世界所有的格斗选手认可。
Yes, that is also one of my thoughts. And honestly, I've gained a lot of honors before, but the reason why I choose one again is that I want to introduce our Chinese MMA, Chinese martial arts, and Chinese kickboxing to the whole world. I believe after everyone's efforts, including my efforts, the world will see how developed China's martial arts, China's kickboxing is.
The only trouble with Haggerty is he has a fight booked in the US against Superlek. We know this. Do you want to wait, or do you want to fight for the interim belt against Petchanong? What do you prefer?
现在有一个临时的金腰带，张的等。他说：“他说哈格蒂的比赛已经在9月份安排好了，所以你是愿意等到他9月份再打完之后，还是说你也愿意说去和帕奇特农打临时金腰带？”嗯，这个我希望，还是通过万冠军赛的这样的一个安排。那如果哈格蒂没有档期，可以打临时金腰带，我觉得也没问题，那就是帕奇特农。如果哈格蒂这个有档期，或者是。 往后排都没问题，我想尽快的还是打这条金腰带。I am
coming for the belt, and so I am okay with the interim belt fight. But as long as Jonathan got the time and he's available for me, I will still accept this challenge. I am coming for the belt.
Can you tell me about the Demon Blade? Who gave you this name? What does the Demon Blade mean to you?
您有一个这个非常霸气的一个外号叫做腰刀，你可以向大家解释一下这个外号是怎么来的吗？腰刀还是最初我用腿法，经常有些时候这个变化多端，然后经常有些时候用腿法
Q 人，所以这个腿大家都这个被命名是一把刀，所以这把刀就是比较腰啊，这个比较腰一点，腰就是这个怪嘛。 对，就是比较怪一点，这种话就是比较怪，然后变幻莫测的那种，所以这个腰刀是从我这个腿这个得来的。Actually,
the nickname of Demon Blade begins originates from my moves of my legs, my kick. I usually use my legs to get my opponents get KO, and that's how it comes from. And the moves of my legs are always unpredictable. It changes very much, and so that's how they give me this name.
And finally, do you have any unfinished business with the sport of mixed martial arts?
那您在 MMA 这个领域还有没有什么未完成的梦想？我曾经也是这个年轻气盛过，我打过一场
MMA 的比赛，然后也就是一回合吧，我就被裸脚了。这个隔行如隔山，所以如果我要是跨界的话，我肯定需要大量的这样的一个。 训练，而且要需要长周期的这个训练系统，长周期的这个系统的训练。所以如果跨界的话，我还是要等我这两年完成我站立踢拳的这样的一个发展与梦想吧，我再去转型，或。 Yes.
As you all know, when I was very young, I used to fight MMA, and then I got a rare naked choke for a very short period of time. I think if I want to fight MMA, probably that's after I got all of my belts, all of my goals achieved in kickboxing. And you know, there are quite different sports, so probably I will do long-term training. It requires a lot of efforts.
So maybe later. Hey, 谢谢你, top man.
Okay.
Thanks a lot.